two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to our channel. We're glad to see you today, and we hope you enjoy this episode. Today, our title is Ashes to Ashes, Dust to Dust. This is based on a challenge from Jim at Hand Tool Restoration, who showed everyone how to return a tool back to its rusty patina state, and issued a challenge to all of us to do the same. So today we are presenting our video showing how we met the challenge and also beat the challenge.
Jim with Hand Tool Restoration recently posted a video where he returned a tool that had been restored back to its original heavy patina condition using some sort of secret formula and challenged us to try and do likewise. Well, I've got a great candidate here in this really nice Tremo wrench that's been beautifully restored. Hate to mess with it, but I can't pass up a challenge. I got to try the challenge. However, I think he was really doing it all wrong. He did get some, a little bit of patina back and distressed the tool quite a bit. But I think patina is the key thing. That's the key part of this whole challenge. So what I'm going to do today is show you how to really bring the patina back. So let's get started. Okay, for my conversion of this tool back to its patina state, we're going to actually bake a finish. We're going to cook it in the microwave. Yeah, I know what you're saying. You're going to put metal and foil in the microwave? Well, it's dangerous, but I want to do this. I want to do this for the community, so I'm going to take the risk. The first thing we do to prepare the tool is cover it with cooking oil. And now for more ingredients. After the oil, then of course we salt it like you would any thing you're cooking. And of course pepper. And red pepper. Coarse red pepper. Be sure and use the coarse. That's what really helps the process. Oh, it's looking good. And some parsley. Unlike those other formulas, which was soaking it in a wet solution, I'm doing this like you would do a dry rub. Next, we have some nice avocado oil. Really helps. When I cook things in the deep fryer, it really helps, so I'm going to try it on here too. Really helps all those ingredients stick. And finally, for the last magic ingredient, we're going to add a little soy sauce. That should really help bring out all that patina we're looking for. Okay, it's time to wrap this sucker up. And put it in the microwave. Again, and I know it's dangerous, but I'm doing it for the community. So, here we go. Well, that was exciting and scary. Let me see what we got here. Whew, that sucker is hot. Let me get some help with this. Ooh, never put Reynolds wrap and steel tools in the microwave. I thought it was going to explode. Let me see what we've got here. Ooh, I can feel the heat coming off of there. Wow! Man, that is really hot. But maybe we got it done right. I hope I didn't undercook it or overcook it, because I'm not going to press that button again. Something's cooking in here. Smells good anyway. Doesn't smell stinky like those other ones. It smells like I cooked a really good meal. Let's see what we got here. Wow, look at that. Look at that. That is great. Patina like you've never seen before. That is wonderful. And it's all baked on there. Dried it out, baked it on, brought out the wonderful patina. Okay, let's see if I can get a closer look. I had to bring in some help with this. Just too hot to pick up. Look at that. Well done all the way through. I mean, that's for Tina to die for. Tina boys would love this. Man, my wife's going to be in here soon, and she's not going to be happy with all this mess I made in the kitchen. But I sure am happy with how this tool turned out. We were looking for patina, and there it is. Okay, all of you patina boys, try to top that one. Jim, are you watching? Rob, are you watching? This is the way you do it. Thanks for watching my video.